Tonight, big Bunnings is watching. The privacy regulator today slamming the hardware heavyweight over its use of facial recognition technology on unsuspecting customers.
It's the iconic Aussie hardware chain that's a weekend wonderland for DIY dads and snag lovers alike. But now Bunnings is under fire, found in breach of privacy laws for using facial recognition technology on its customers without their knowledge or consent.
Bunnings had facial recognition technology deployed on their CCTV cameras in their stores. They could have had signs up throughout the store. They could have had more information in their privacy policy. They didn't sufficiently meet that requirement to be transparent with users.
The findings are the result of a two-year investigation, which found the retail giant breached the privacy of hundreds of thousands of customers across 63 of its stores in New South Wales and Victoria between 2018 and 2021.
Facial recognition is the canary in the coal mine of AI out in public usage. People are genuinely really concerned about the fact that they don't have a lot of control about where their personal information goes.
Bunnings says it used the technology to protect staff and customers from increasing exposure to violence and organised crime by identifying repeat offenders entering stores.
It's all about safety at the end of the day. Using technology like facial recognition technology is proven to help reduce the incidence of crime in retail environments.
The retailer plans to seek a review of the ruling, claiming the collected data was usually deleted almost instantly.
I think it fails the common sense test. The data that was captured was held for 4.17 milliseconds, or less than the blink of an eye.
Bunnings isn't alone. A choice investigation finding the Good Guys and Kmart also use facial recognition technology, which is becoming more widespread.
I suspect we may have a lot more complaints coming out of the woodwork following this. I've had the sense that many retailers and organisations have been waiting for the Bunnings decision in order to think about whether they use this technology themselves going forward.
So what does this all mean for the future of Aussie customers and the businesses keeping an eye on us?
Well, we're live tonight from the lands of the Kulin Nation. We're going to talk a bit more about this, and here to tell us more is cybersecurity expert Professor Richard Buckland. Obviously, when we hear this, it all sounds pretty alarming, but I wonder how many of the other companies are doing this as well.
Yeah, I mean, we were lucky that Choice found out. We wouldn't have known otherwise because they weren't telling anyone. From what the Privacy Commissioner said, sounds like she thinks it's a far more widespread practice now. I mean, it's so easy to do and everyone has cameras, so we don't know, and this might well flush it out of the woodwork, but I expect it's being done quite widely.
Professor, what could a corporation do with this biometric data that they're harvesting?
Well, their stated purpose they can do, of course, which is to detect shoplifters that they already know about and get a flag when they enter the store. But if they keep the data, then there's all sorts of things they can do with it, I guess. They could monitor your behaviour as you walk around the store. They could work out where you pause and where you stop, and so deliver targeted ads to you. They could classify you into different sorts of categories. They could work out if you're impulsive, like we do with children, and we put chocolate at the checkout aisle. They could do an equivalent. For me, it'd be a power tool. They can put a, if they watch me pausing at the power tool aisle, I can know that. So I guess that sounds silly, but basically they just know everything you do in the store. And of course, it could be aggregated then with other stores. It could be aggregated with security cameras in the shopping center. Once it's allowed, then you could be tracked continually, and what you do and what you think and your facial expressions and everything now could be fair game. Of course, that's in the future, but it's not that far in the future, so it's good that we're thinking about it now.
Well, you know, because there's a tendency for people to say, oh, well, if you're not doing anything wrong, you've got nothing to hide. But then when you look at countries like China, where there's a social credit score or whatever, and where you can't get access to certain things if you haven't thought the right way or acted the right way, but how can people fight back against that thinking?
Yes, and the same in Hong Kong. I'm sure the people in Hong Kong thought they were safe, and they were safe initially, perhaps when the data was collected. But the problem is you have to keep the data safe from then on because it's never deleted. And if there is a regime change or you get a crazy president or prime minister or there's a collapse in the rule of law, I mean, who knows, you know, what could happen politically.
Is the answer for Kate to do what they did in Hong Kong and go everywhere with an umbrella, even in Bunnings?
Hide the face, love it.
Hide the face.
Well, yeah.
Professor, my sausage in one hand and my umbrella in the other.
Well, apparently now they can identify you from your sausage, so, you know, I think you'd have to keep the sausage under
the
umbrella.
Get the camera out of there.
I thought I was only good at that. Hey,
says that this is all done for security reasons. Do you think that's a valid argument?
Yeah, I mean, I can understand why they did it. I mean, I completely understand them making that argument. They were doing it for good, and it's pretty hard to argue with it's protecting staff. But the problem is they were doing it secretly. They weren't looking after or monitoring the data. They didn't have independent scrutiny. So at any time, they could have decided to do what we call scope creep. They could have decided, yeah, well, now we've got this data. Let's start looking at shopping habits of people. Let's start working out if different racial groups do different things. Let's start giving this data to the police or ASIO or Facebook or, you know, those steps were just one step away. So, yeah, although the initial action was good, the Privacy Commissioner is rightly saying, but what happens next? That's what we're interested in.
Professor Buckland, thanks very much for your time this evening. And, of course, the Bunnings full statement is on our website.
It's a pleasure.
I feel like there's a bit we need to talk about there.
Mm. I do too. And you know what it reminds me of? Hunted.
Oh, the my great Channel
goodness.
10 program.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
And when I watch it, I can't sleep.
Oh.
Yeah.
But are you a bit paranoid? Is that why you're so worried about this?
Well, see, now that's interesting terminology, Hamish. Am I paranoid or do I just live in this world?
Wow.
I mean,
okay.
You tell
me. Open your eyes, sheeple, Hamish. Listen to the woman. She's making perfect sense here.
But is that not a device that we're all just ha 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 as we march to our own demise?
But hang on, I've seen
to be
you...
crushed by the cogs of capitalism.
But you sit there flicking away on your social media apps and all the rest of it. You give them all
exactly.
your data.
Yeah, I know. Oh my God, TikTok forever.